The scent of blood drew Carl on. He told himself it wasn't bad. The dinner had struggled a little too much. The sheer quantity of blood broke through his lie, and he increased his pace. Some of the adolescents could have gotten too rowdy and simply lost control. It wasn't unheard of during the first changes. Carl had the scars to attest to his own troubled youth. He saw the first human body and couldn't maintain any hope. Heart in his throat, Carl raced to the clan hold, change building beneath his skin. It'd be easier to deal with a threat in his wolfen form, but the scent would be stronger then, possibly sending him into a frenzy. He ran on two legs, looking human. There was no threat to deal with at the clan hold. The battle had ended hours ago, any survivors gone. Carl stared at the carnage, stunned. Several humans had been torn apart, their weapons gleaming of silver. Blood soaked into the clearing, dark in the sunlight. In the very center of the clearing was a wolfen baby, obscured by gore. Carl went numb, mind attempting to deny what he was seeing. The clan slaughtered. Humans had found them, had attacked them. More humans would be coming, or could be looking for other wolfen clans. He stumbled to the longhouse, searching faces as he found more dead clan members. Everyone he'd loved was at his feet, but he didn't understand what that really meant. His subconscious was protecting him from insanity. The longhouse was where they'd made their stand. The doors were bashed in, shattered and hanging from their hinges. Wolfen warriors had been hacked apart in various stages of the change. The room was awash in gore and stank worse than in the abattoir. Carl walked past more humans, more silver weapons, more dead children. His focus was the head of the room, the throne of their clan. His father's throne. The clan's trophies were blood-stained, some pulled from the walls. There was nothing that wasn't touched by violence. The throne was on its side, body parts clinging to it. His father lay, broken and wounded, in front of the throne. Carl dashed to his side, touching his shoulder. What could he do to fix this? And the clan leader groaned, eyes fluttering open. Carl. Disbelief filled the other wolfen's voice. How did you survive? Guilt stabbed at him and Carl closed his eyes. Had he not been with his human lover, he would have been here, would have fought, and died. I'm sorry. His father tried to squeeze Carl's hand. Avenge us. Carl nodded vigorously, opening his eyes. Yes, of course. Then his father died. The last member of the Blood Hills clan howled his grief to the sky. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe, share with others. Social media links are below in the description. See you next time.